Very good morning to everyone. Today we are going to start the new concept of the rational numbers, that is division of rational numbers. Last week we have discussed multiplication of any 2, any 3 for rational numbers, right? Today we are going to discuss how we can divide any 2, 3, 4 rational numbers, right? So one thing I want to tell you, like if you are, there is a sign in between any 2 rational numbers. Okay, so for this is an example I am giving you. So your first step is, when you are going for division of any 2 rational numbers, your first step should be that you have to replace the sign of division with the help of
reciprocal.
In place of division, you have to place the sign of multiplication. 2 by 3 will come and this will multiply. The next term will be automatically
reciprocal.
It will go in the inverse. Punch, everything fine? 6 upon 5. Okay. Now you need to check it out. Can we cancel the numerators and denominators from anywhere? Can we cancel?
Yes.
Here and here we can't cancel. Here and here can't cancel. 2, 5, no. 6 and 3?
Yes.
3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. Answer will be 2 twos are
4.
5 ones are
5.
In this way we compute the division of the rational numbers. 2 twos are 4. Okay. In this way we compute the, like here, whatever we have done here, this we have done in the last week. Multiplication of rational numbers. Okay. From here we have started in the last week. Okay. And now in this division, only this statement is there. You have to change the statement in the multiplication. But when you place this multiply sign in place of division, immediately the next term will go in the reciprocal. Only this is the main concept. Right? So let's start with the questions. Yeah, first question is find out the reciprocal or the multiplication inverse. The name given to reciprocal in your paper, I can give you a question like find out the multiplicative inverse. So please don't get confused. Multiplicative inverse, right? Multiplicative inverse meaning is reciprocal of the rational numbers, right? So I'm writing here all the questions, so you have to answer all the parts one by one. Right? First part is 11. First part is 11. Please tell me, reciprocal of 11.
Very
good. Reciprocal of second part is minus 6. Please tell me. 1 upon minus 6, or one more thing, 1 upon minus 6 means this minus sign. I told in the classes also, early classes. If minus sign is given in the numerator or in the denominator, that is the common sign for both. I can write here minus and this is 1 upon 6. I can write in this way also. Both things are same. If anyone has written in the paper in this way, answer will be absolutely correct. If you will write in this way, answer will be absolutely correct. Okay, fine. So don't get confused. So sometime I am writing this way, don't get confused. Ma'am, sign was here, why you have taken here? They are not my friends, I can take anywhere, right? 3 by 7.
7 by 3. 7 by 7.
Very good. That will be equal to 7 by 3. Okay. Fourth part. What part is? 3 upon minus 13. It will be? Okay. Fifth part is?
Minus
4 upon 9. Give me the answer.
9 upon minus 4.
Very good. Sixth part. Minus 3, minus 5. First of all, compute this minus 3, minus 5. What is this? Whenever sign is given you in the numerator and in denominator, they will immediately cancel in the beginning. Okay, initially cancel. Yeah, I'm writing here, okay? You can write it this way. This is 0.1 if nothing is given. Suppose this is question is 5. If anyone will ask you, this 5 is a simple digit. Is it a rational number?
Yes, ma'am.
What you will say?
5/1.
Is it a rational number?
Yes,
or any integer?
Yes, ma'am.
Abijod, it is a integer or a rational number?
Both.
Huh?
Both.
Very good. If any single digit is given to you, you can write 1 in the numerator. Okay, so it means it is 0.1. So 0.1 means 1 upon 0. Whenever 0 comes in the denominator, that will be not defined. We can't compute it. Okay, we can't solve it further in further steps. Okay, clear?
Yes.
Show me. Okay. Clear, everyone?
Yes.
Girls, Gatik, Devansh, Harman, clear? Girl? Okay. So no need to write anything, okay? You will get everything in the PDF and video also you will give. So let's start the second question. In the second question, now you have to go for the division by computing the terms. Okay, divide. Question is 9 upon 16 divided by 3 upon 4. Okay, so please look here. You have to solve in this way. First of all, remove by. Remove by with division. You are doing the questions of division. First of all, write division in place of by. Now in the next step, remove this division with the
multiplication.
That will be
4/3.
Now please tell me, that will be
4/3.
Now can we cancel?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
On which table?
4/4.
3/3.
What will be the answer?
3/4. 4/4.
This will be your answer. Okay, and check the sign also. If any sign is given to you, negative, positive, please keep it. Okay, in the answer. If any one sign is there of negative, write negative in the answer. If both are negative, negative, answer will be
positive.
Okay, any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Right now, everyone will do third part in their practice notebooks. Quickly. I'm writing statement here, third part. Try to solve third part right now. Second part you can mark, that is for the homework. Third part. Okay, third part is 56 upon 7 by minus 8 upon 14. No one will change this by in the first step with the multiplication. First of all, change with the division sign. In the next step, change with the multiplication sign. Quickly do it. Minus 9 upon 5. This is your fifth part. Quickly. done very good. Let them solve. Done answer? Then it will be?
Mom,
it will be how much?
Mom.
Just wait. Some are confused with language. Zero, division sign you have to write here, multiplication, okay? Minus 9 upon 5 is equal to how much?
5
upon minus 9. When zero will multiply with anything, don't write here like in this way, zero with this, zero divide by minus 9, no, nothing, okay? When you are multiplying zero with any term, integer, negative, positive, or a fraction, anything, that will be?
Zero.
Only zero. That will be? Only zero. Got it? Devansh? Done? Harman? Okay. Now one more part. Seventh part. Rest will be your homework. Seventh part. Quickly do it and give me the answer. Seventh part. Note down minus 105 divided by 11. Okay. You have divided this by minus 15 upon 121. Quickly do it. Quickly. Very good. Very good. Just wait. Let them do once. Have I kept anywhere the bottle of ink? Have I got? Yeah. Give me answer, Abhijot.
77.
Okay. Kartik, answer. Multiply, open it, whatever answer will be there, then go for the multiplication with the third term. Quickly. to solve this question. Quickly, hurry up. Bring in the water. How many of you have solved? 1, 2, 3, 4. Very good. Hurry up, hurry up. It's very, very easy. Open the bracket and then multiply with the third term. Okay, just wait. 5 points, very good. Those who have done, very good. Apni done. Shakun done. Shopit. Devansh. Harman. Harman, why so slow? Getting the concept, Devansh? Are you getting the concept? How we are solving the questions, how we are doing with the division and multiplication, how we are opening the bracket. Alright, now see. Open the bracket. Okay, 2 by 30 multiply 7 upon 1 multiply by 26 upon 14. No noise. Can I cancel anything?
Yes, ma'am.
What do I cancel?
No, ma'am.
No, 2 sevens are? Divided by 13. Okay, now bracket is, I'm removing the bracket. Okay, now I'm removing the bracket. I'm writing this multiply sign here and third down here. Now go for the cancel.
Yes,
can I cancel?
Yes,
13 ones are 13. My answer is
2.
If you are writing next is equal to in the same line, please show in this way. Okay, right? So this is your answer. Okay, any doubt? Yeah?
Now we can cancel since we get directly also cancel after opening the bracket.
After opening the bracket?
We can cancel directly also opening.
First of all, bracket should be removed. Okay, if bracket is there, means the gates are closed. No one can enter. No one can go. Right, remove it. Okay? Now, start with the next question. Second part. And third part, please tell me which part I'll solve in the class. Please see one, second part and third part.
Second part.
What do I mean? Huh? Tuition. Please bring it on daily basis, okay? Yes, second or third?
Second. Fine.
Second part. Part is minus 3 upon 5 multiply by 15 upon 2. Try this question once by on. Okay, and then I'll start the solution. Minus 9 upon 4 divided by 2 by 3. Those who are not having book, please note down the statement and start doing. First of all, solve the brackets, both the brackets. When everything will be solved, then you will remove the bracket. Not before that. First of all, solve this bracket. Okay, this will be as it is. Solve the second bracket in that line only. Okay, in the next step, brackets will be removed and then you can solve the terms. Just hurry up. Multiply 3 by 2. We can get cancel anything?
Yes, ma'am.
No, we can't cancel. Shotgun, have you cancelled in this way? 9 and 3. Okay, fine. Now, minus 3 into 3. Minus 3 into 3. Minus 3 into 3.
Minus
9. Upon? Okay, I open the bracket in next step. Okay, division sign. Minus 9 into 3. 9 threes are? 27. Divide by 4, 2s are?
8.
Now I'm going to open the bracket and I'll write the division sign here. Minus 9 by 2. Okay, I'm removing division sign. I'm writing a multiply. Next term will be?
8 upon 4 minus 9.
Okay, write here minus of here. Okay, now can you cancel anything?
Yes.
2 ones are, 2 fours are, 9 ones are, 9 threes are. Okay.
4 upon 3.
And check the sign. Minus, minus will become plus. Will become plus. Anything? Any doubt? Done or is not? You have done. Other students, who's done? Shopping? Harman, understood also? Girls, Amni? Shagun? Yes, you? So now, next question will be your homework. And fourth part. Tell me fourth part. Should I do here or at home? Fourth part. Should I do in the class or?
Homework.
Raise your hands if I have two here. How many votes are there? But I have two here in the class. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Very good. So let's start. Write down the statement of fourth part. Try this question once and then I'll solve on the board. I'll ask you. What is the first step? Statement is, in the first bracket, now you're having three terms. Minus 4 upon 11. Multiply 7 upon 13 divided by 1 upon 26 divided by 7 upon minus 22. Okay, now please solve it. In the first bracket you are having 3 terms. 3 terms. Quickly solve this question.
First
you
have to solve divide.
Remove divide. Okay, in place of divide multiply will come. Now compute all these three terms. No worries, I'll do here on the board. Done? Very good. Right? So the way you are solving two terms same way you have to compute these three
possible try what they are saying. Okay, what is the meaning of the statement? Quickly, say to it. Divide the sum of 2 by 7 and 3 by 11 by the product of 1 by 7 and minus 4, 43 upon 2. Please tell me what is the meaning of this line. Please tell me. Just write down first line. Okay, please tell me the first line. They are saying divide the sum of 2 by 7 and 3 by 11. Divide the sum of this, divide it with the product of 1 by 7 and minus 43 upon 2. This is the question. This is the question. Okay, they have given you in the form of sentence. So try to understand. They are saying find out the sum of this, divide the sum of these two terms, divide. Divide the sum of these two terms with the product of these two terms. Any doubt? Any doubt? Okay, you can note down this first line. Okay, this question is your homework question. Right? So you have to solve this first bracket. Okay. With the help of what? With the help of what? With the help of LCM. LCM. Addition sign is there. Then here multiply. Multiply sign is there, okay, then division, okay, right? So your homework is up to 4 questions of this exercise and later we'll start by tomorrow in the class, fine? Okay, please note down this.